Good morning, everyone. This is your good old neighbor, Naked Confusion 2, and Nope, Time to Die fan 2020. And welcome back to another movie review on Jurassic Park and War, leading up to that Jurassic World 3. I forgot what the bottom of the title is, but it was too complicated to talk about anyway. Anyway, guys, so after we got done reviewing all the three Jurassic Park movie, so sorry that I already watched the movie before, and why not? I'm probably this movie is not on FX because I've been checking on FX. This movie is not on FX, so at least I watched it before, and I know everything about this movie. I know it about the story, I know it about the character, I know about the action, I know everything, especially in that amazing scene when Chris Pratt riding a motorcycle. Yeah, it's kind of remind me of Dan Aykroyd riding a motorcycle and No Time to Die. So anyway, guys, so today I'm doing a movie review, which is a way better Jurassic movie than Jurassic Park 3, which honestly, don't let me get started. I talk about that piece of garbage movie because that movie is honestly one of the worst Jurassic movies I ever seen in my life. So thank God we're gonna get to the good review for once. So today, I'm doing a movie review on Jurassic World starring Chris Pratt. Came out the year of 2015, the same year of Sponge Out of the Water, The Martian, and my favorite movie of 2015 is had to be Spectre starring Dan Aykroyd. Because every time I think about a movie, a lot of time, yeah, that movie deserved to be my number one best movie of 2015. Even I like The Kingsman, The Secret Service, but I think Spectre is a way better 2015 movie than The Secret Service. Anyway, guys, I don't want to give it away because I don't want to get the huge major spoiler for this movie. I don't care this, and honestly, I don't give a monkey that this movie came out 2015, which honestly, I don't want to give away spoiler to great movie. I do it for bad movies, so yeah. So hey guys, let's get my thought on this movie, shall we? So hey guys, I watched this movie before. Hey, do you know why would I watch it? I watched it at school. That's right. Years ago, I watched this movie at school back in 2017. We was having the movie day, and I was like, how about we watch Jurassic World? Because I've been picking up a DVD, and I was like, Jurassic World? What is that movie? Is that a movie about dinosaurs? Yeah. I enjoyed Jurassic Park. I really enjoyed the sequel, but I did not like the third movie. But let's give this Jurassic World movie a little greatness. And so, hey guys, after teacher put it in, and I was pretty going to rewatch it, and honestly, there was no need to rewatch it because this movie is such an awesome masterpiece, but there was no need to rewatch it. The same thing with The Fallen Kingdom, which honestly, I'm not going to rewatch Fallen Kingdom because I already watched that movie last year because that movie was honestly one of the weakest out of the record movies, and I don't understand why Grace Runner liked the movie, and I don't understand why Grace Runner do a 100 video about Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. And honestly, guys, after I watched this movie, in this movie, I gotta say, I really love this movie. And this movie is my number 8 best movie of the year of 2015. I think 2015 is such a great year for movies. And I know we got Terrible Movie Like Vacation, Taken 3, Fame Full Stick, Hagen Back. Oh man, don't want to get started. I talk about that piece of garbage. So hey guys, so at least this movie, because after I saw the Super Bowl TV TV spot of this movie, Yeah, I was so looking forward to this movie. But sadly, I didn't get the chance to see this movie in theaters because it came out on June 12th, and I was spending time with the family back then because I was a kid. So, yeah. So, you guys, but now I'm a grown man, and I will choose my own decision if I'm going to go outside or not. You can't force me to. And so, you guys, well, even this movie is greatness, but I still have some one flaws about this movie. I still have some one flaw about this movie. No, people, I'm not going to say the villain because I don't want to get into villain hate. But the one thing I really do not like that movie is has to be the new kid actor. Because the one kid actor, especially two kids actor, because he was in that Jurassic World theme park, which I want to say that theme park works amazing. I'll probably this is my third favorite theme park. My number two in Universal Studio. My number one is Walt Disney World. I really love Disney World. I really want to come back at Disney World in the future because that Jurassic World theme park, oh my, chef kiss. But The only negative I have for this movie, it has to be that two kid actor, which honestly, the tall kid and then the little child kid. Honestly, I honestly do not like those kids at all. I really do not like it one bit because every time I see them on the screen, it's kind of feel like I am watching a different movie. It's kind of feel like I am watching because his name is, I think, Zach, and the other one, I think his name is, let me type in my Google searches, I think his name is Gray, honestly. I hate to say it, but Gray Mature, this has to be one of the worst characters of the movie, because I really do not like that kid at all, and that teenager kid, Zach. Oh my goodness, I am not a fan of the actor voiced by a kid. Zach and Gray, oh man, such a terrible kid. I don't know, one of the kid actor I have ever seen for Universal, period. Sorry guys, and I know Frozen will be really disagree with my negative, which honestly is my YouTube channel. I can do what I want, because you got your own YouTube channel, I got my own YouTube channel, so... So you can do your own negative in your channel, but this is my channel, you don't own it anymore, so you got your YouTube channel, and I got my YouTube channel, so that's good. But the bottom line is, I really not a fan, because I never liked the kid actor in the first place, because I never liked it in the beginning with, so even this movie is greatness, but this movie should be a 10 out of 10, but this movie is a 9 out of 10, why? Because Gray and Zach kind of ruined for me. So I'm just... Honestly, guys, I really do not like the kid actor. Kid actor is honestly one of the worst actors I've ever seen for Universal. So honestly, guys, that's the only one fault I have for this movie. It has to be the kid, honestly. Not a huge fan of it. Thank God he's not in the sequel. Thank God he's not going to be in the third movies. Good day, sir. And sorry, guys, let's get the positive of this movie, shall we? I do, man. I think the story is really creative, which honestly, they took the story for Jurassic Park 3 and made it to the greatness, because Jurassic Park 3, that movie made me done with Jurassic movie, but after this movie, I came back to be a fanboy of Jurassic World. And I do, man. I really like Chris Pratt in the movie. Chris Pratt of this movie, this has got to be one of the second best performances he ever did. My number third is Emmett from the Jurassic movies, and honestly, my number one best Chris Pratt performance, this has to be Star-Lord from the Guardians of the Galaxy movie and the Avengers movie. Yeah, he's in the Avengers movie. No fun for that. And sorry, guys, my favorite character in the movie, it has to be... Carol, I think. I think what's her red hair girl name is. She is such a beauty. I really love her. Every time I see her on the screen, I kind of feel like I have a crush on her. So, yeah. And honestly, she is such a beauty. I don't know, one of my favorite characters in the movie. She is way better than the kid actor in this movie. Zach and Gray, I don't like it. Sorry, guys. And the villain of this movie is a really awesome villain of the movie. And the villain of this movie is a pretty awesome villain. I really enjoyed the villain of this movie. He was an amazing villain of the movie. So, yeah. And the climax of this movie is honestly one of my favorite scenes of the movie. Oh, wait a minute. My favorite scene of this movie, it had to be the iconic scene when Chris Pratt riding the motorcycle, trying to be like James Bond, and why the dinosaur chasing. Honestly, that scene is iconic. That scene is amazing. That scene is honestly one of my favorite scenes of the movie. Reason why? Because I have the same spirit just like Jane Bond from No Time to Die. When I was waiting back in from No Time to Die, it came out. Because No Time to Die came out 2021. And this movie came out 2015. So that was way before that No Time to Die came along. And sorry, guys. And so, sorry, guys. I have nothing to say about this movie. Because the reason why I want to do this review real quick, except re-watching it, is because I had to spend time with my sis today. And I got to do Freeman requests. My go away, at least her request is not more difficult, so yeah. Not even Frozen request is not even difficult at all. So overall, guys, Jurassic World is really awesome movie. Well, even the, honestly, well, even this movie has some one fall, which is Gray and Zach. Honestly, I am not a huge fan of that kid. And thank God those two actors, kid actors, not in the sequel and not in the third movies. Or else you're going to ruin the movie for me. And so, hey guys, and this movie is honestly one of my number 8 favorite movie of the year, 2015. Well, even I enjoy the movie, but I think Spectre starting Daniel Craig is a way better movie than Joe Record Ball. And so, hey guys, that's enough talking. Let's get started this rating, shall we? I'm gonna get Joe Record Ball a 9 out of 10. I love it, and this movie deserves a CU of naked awesomeness. And stay tuned for my movie review tomorrow on Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. Or you want me to do it tonight because just want to get this out of the way. Because I'm going to hang out with my sis today. And I'm going to have a fun time today. So no, people, I'm not going to go swimming because I already swimming yesterday. And so, hey guys, that was my movie review on Jurassic World. So no need to rewatch it because I know everything about the movie. I know the story. I know the character. I know all a bunch of movie. And no, people, I didn't cheat. And no, people, I didn't work up my research. Nope, I didn't do anything. Sorry about that, I just like to fool you. Anyway, guys, so that was my movie review on Jurassic World. This is a way better movie than Jurassic Part 3. That's that movie. And so, hey guys, and stay tuned for my movie review on Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, which honestly one of the weakest out of the Jurassic World movies in history. Because that movie is not very good at all. But at least that movie is way better than The Happy Time Murders. Hate that movie. F that movie. I would do a win of that movie on anniversary. Stupid. And so, hey guys, if you liked another dinosaur video, please hit the subscribe button, turn notification, and show this family. And so, yeah, and stay tuned for my movie review on Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. It's not gonna be a win, it's gonna be a just review because I don't want to take that movie way too seriously. So, and so, yeah, and that movie is a huge, mediocre bag. A mediocre. So, yeah. And so, let's say Jurassic World 3 is would be a much better movie than Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom. I do not like that movie. That movie is not very good, but it's not going to be a win. It's going to be a simple review because I have a lot of stuff to talk about. And so, hey guys, subscribe, comment, share to his family. And honestly, you can request me any win, any review you want. But the rule is, do not request me to do a baby show win. Do not request me to do a preschool show win, and please do not request me to do a character win. And I swear to God, if I see those requests of those three things, which I don't want to do, I'm just going to remove the comment, or else I would annoy it. You know what, it's the best I annoy it, so yeah. So hey guys, you know the drill, request me anything you want. You want me to do the review on a video game, on Superman 64, I will be welcome to do that because that video game is terrible. Seriously, flying the wings and picking up cars, who made a video game called? Because it's I can't imagine that a Nintendo 64 will greenlight a Elsa game. All she do is ice. I don't like that game idea. I will make a much better game than that crap. That would be the worst frozen game I ever played. Oh well. And so, hey guys, I'm done for today. So stay tuned for my movie review on Jurassic World Fallen Kingdom, which is going to be my last review leading up to that Jurassic World Dimension, aka Jurassic World 3. Because all the returning in the first movie is coming back. Well, except John, because he passed away back in 2014. Yeah. Kind of shame that he passed away. So that's why he was not in the third movie in the first place. But thank God he's not in the third movie because I don't want him to suffer in the third movie. And so, hey guys, I'm done for today. So subscribe, comment, share to find me. Stay tuned for my movie review on Jurassic World 2, aka The Fallen Kingdom, which is honestly one of the weakest out of the Jurassic World movies. And so, hey guys, I see you next time. And so long, and peace, YouTube. Have a great day, and I see you guys next time.